The Quranic story of creation is simple, beautiful, and full of metaphorical meaning. In the Islamic tradition, angels were created from light. Among the angels was a different creature who was made from fire, a jinn named Iblis. After creating Adam, who was to be the custodian of the earth, God told the angels to bow down to this new man. The angels complied with God's command and bowed to Adam. But Iblis, the jinn, didn't. So God asked Iblis why he didn't obey the command. قَالَ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَلَّا تَسْجُدُ إِذْ أَمَرْتُكَ Iblis responded, قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ تِينَ I am better than him. You made me from fire and him from clay. There is more to the story, but let's reflect that the first chronological sin in creation was Iblis's arrogance because of Adam's humble origin. 12 verses in the Quran confirm that all mankind was made from clay, including the following one from the chapter entitled The Believers, Surah Al-Mu'minun. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ تِينٍ And indeed, we created man out of the essence of clay. Yet our bodies today are not composed of clay. So what do these verses mean? Why clay? Clay is composed of fine-grained inorganic minerals that are less than 2 micrometers in diameter. That's about 8/10,000ths of an inch. These inorganic minerals are called phyllosilicates, which means they have a layered structure. When clays get wet, the layers in these sheets can slide past each other, which allows the clay to be molded. Then, when the clay is dried or fired, it hardens and retains its shape. Different minerals give clays different properties, such as the amount of water they can absorb. Clays can also contain different amounts of organic matter, which influence color, plasticity, and firing properties. When scientists talk about organic matter, they are not talking about expensive vegetables in grocery stores. To scientists, organic matter consists of carbon-based compounds that are necessary for life. All living organisms are comprised of cells. A human adult may have as many as 30 trillion cells. That number is doubled if you include helpful bacteria in our bodies. That's 60 trillion cells. And each of those cells needs 4 fundamental organic components to live. Sugars to store energy, amino acids, the building blocks of the proteins that perform various cell functions, nucleic acids, which store and transmit genetic information, and lipids, which form the cellular membranes that encapsulate and protect the cell's contents. A big question for scientists is how the Earth went from the inorganic world of 4.5 billion years ago to today's world, which contains a biomass of 550 gigatons. Biomass is the amount of carbon in living organisms. How much carbon exists in today's life? The Earth also has 3,900 gigatons of carbon in the form of fossil fuels, the decayed remains of ancient life. So how did we get from a planet devoid of organic compounds to where we are today? That process is called abiogenesis. According to science, it may have all started with clay. Before we explore the scientific theory on how inorganic clay started the process of creating organic life, it is interesting to note the idea of life starting from clay is surprising, but it didn't start with scientists. The Quran mentions it twice as a miracle by the prophet Jesus, who, translated in English, is reported to have said, "I have come to you with a sign from your Lord. I will make for you a bird from clay. Breathe into it, and it will become a real bird, by God's will." That story in the Quran is interpreted by most scholars as a miracle, and an example of God giving Jesus the ability to break the normal rules of science that God created. However, unlike Jesus' bird, the creation of mankind from clay doesn't seem to be positioned as a miracle. The verses before or after the verses mentioning clay as man's origin reflect a broader creation process. How did organic molecules form and accumulate in an inorganic world? One theory suggests that clay minerals on early Earth provided a surface for inorganic molecules to adsorb onto, protecting these molecules from environmental hazards and bringing them into close proximity with each other to catalyze the formation of more complex organic structures. Clays also help to chain them together to build larger component molecules by taking on the role of catalyst. A catalyst is a substance that helps chemical reactions take place without being used up in the process. So the catalytic properties of clay promote polymerization reactions, the chaining of the like molecules into larger ones. The essential property of clays that allow it to perform these catalytic activity is the metal ions found within the clay matrix. So the first organic molecules on Earth were created from clay's metal ion essence. The Quran says, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ تِينٍ. We created man from the essence of clay. Subhanallah. Furthermore, clay is mentioned in five different ways in the Quran. Mankind was mintin, or from clay. This is mentioned seven times. Mintin lazib, or from sticky clay. Min sulalatin mintin, or from the essence of clay. Min salsalin kal fakhar, from sounding clay like the potters. Min salsalin min hama'in masnoon, or from sounding clay from altered black mud. Why did the Quran mention man's origin from clay in five different ways? Could the Quran be describing a progression? Let's look at clay as it accumulates organic compounds over five phases. So the five phases of clay as it produces and stores organic matter seems to correspond with the five ways clay is described in the Quran. Double subhanAllah. One last point. Other competing theories exist about the origins of Earth's first organic compounds. A second theory suggests organic compounds originated at deep sea hydrothermal events, as seawater seeped through the Earth's crust and came in contact with magma that was as hot as 1200 degrees Celsius. It heated, rose, and was expelled through vents in the ocean floor. And that heat energy could have powered the formation of organic chemicals. In fact, even today, we see microbial life in these dark, hot, mineral-rich environments performing chemosynthesis. A final theory suggests that organic chemicals were formed in the air or water triggered by ultraviolet light from the sun. The chemicals then fell from the atmosphere, eventually accumulating on land in pools called primordial soup. So according to these three theories, organic compounds were either created by the catalytic ability of metal ions in clay, the energy of 1200 degree magma transferred to seawater, the sun's light energy, or possibly all three. In striking similarity, the Islamic teachings say that man was created from the essence of clay, the jinn from a smokeless fire, perhaps not unlike 1200 degree magma, and the angels from light. What do you think? Is there a metaphorical meaning to the story of creation in the Quran that could refer to prebiotic chemistry? Are these similarities mere coincidences, or do they reveal a connection? Join the conversation in the comments below. In all cases, triple subhanAllah. The point of this episode is that when the Quran describes mankind's origins from clay, it may be referring to the development of the first organic matter in the larger process of abiogenesis. The five ways the Quran describes man's origin from clay might reflect different phases of clay as it catalyzed and accumulated organic matter over millions of years. The three major competing theories of the origins of organic compounds seem strikingly similar to the origins of man, jinn, and angels, as mentioned in the Quran and authentic hadith. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.